Hello, my fellow Air Pirates. I am Air Pirate Sid, and this is the start of my brand new side let's play, Mega Man X, as I'm pretty sure you already read from the title. I think that's why you're here, actually, just to watch this. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and explain a couple of things. One is that this video, actually, anything that I record through composite cables probably won't be as great of quality as I have been hoping for, because a lot of mishaps have happened within the past 12 hours, like, seriously, that I have tried to record this. And this is probably the 7th or 8th time that I have seriously tried recording this video. I'm not even joking. Because the first problem was that I have component cables for my PlayStation 2. Whenever I had it plugged up to my HD PVR going to my TV, it was working fine at this point. But as soon as I selected one of these games right here, I'm not sure if it works on these three, but I do know it was these, it decided to say, oh no, this is an invalid signal, we cannot process this, or something like that, and I had to go back to using my composite cables just to freaking play these games. And that was very irritable, and I have no idea why it did it, but my only prediction is maybe because the Mega Man X games, or at least the first three, were originally on the Super Nintendo, which back then didn't even have, they couldn't even dream of the whole entire component cable system. Anyways, enough of that. I don't feel like talking about it. Everything is fine. Everything will be cool. Everything is good. I'm playing Mega Man X, because, oh boy, it's a Mega Man. And for those of you who actually understand this reference, which I already know that at least one of you should, I will love you. But yeah, there we go. Mega Man X is actually one of my favorite games from my childhood, and I used to actually have it on Super Nintendo, but I kind of lost it somewhere. Don't know where, don't really care at this point, because I have it again on the PlayStation 2. And the Mega Man X collection was released on both the GameCube and the PlayStation 2 back in 2004, and it has the first 6 X games on it, and it has one other one, which is like some kind of racing game that was never released in the US. So that's pretty cool. And from what I understand, in order to unlock it, you have to beat Mega Man X 1, 2, and 3. Which I've only beaten 1, to be honest. Just kind of doing like a little test run of it. But anyways, let's read lines, because that's what I do. X is the first of a new generation of robots, which contain an innovative new feature, the ability to think, feel, and make their own decisions. However, this ability can be very dangerous. If X were to break the first rule of robotics, a robot must never harm a human being, the results would be disastrous, and I fear that they probably would make a movie out of it called iRobot. Approximately 30 years will be required before we could safely confirm his reliability. Unfortunately, I will not live to see that day, nor do I have anyone to carry on my work, because I have been living alone for the past 80 years. Therefore, I have decided to seal him in this capsule, which will test his internal systems until his reliability has been confirmed. Please do not disturb the capsule until that time. X possesses great risks as well as great possibilities. I can only hope for the best. September 18th, 20XX, Thomas Light. Now, it's kind of sad that he doesn't have, like, an apprentice or anything to really hand down his work to. But, let me give you a little bit of the story if you don't already know. Pretty much whenever you saw the whole entire login stuff from Dr. Kane, he dug up, Dr. Light's old laboratory. And whenever he did, he found X in the capsule there, and he decided to bring him back up, and we're Mega Man X. We were dug up. So, here we go, we're in the intro stage right here, and the button schemes are the following. If you hit X, you jump, if you hit square, you shoot lemons, and if you hold the shoot button, you can shoot a green blasty thing, or if you even hold it longer, you can shoot a Kamehameha wave, because you're that epic. I was going to say that you could shoot a Hadouken, but you can actually get that later on in the game, it's a secret, so there you go. I just like jumping over those cars, just because, like, whenever I was a kid and I first played this, I always thought that it was like some kind of error or something, that you should have gotten hit by the cars, but you didn't, and this is before my brain could process the fact that oh yeah, it was already programmed like that, so you're not meant to get hit. So, there you go. That shows you how bright of a kid I was whenever playing games. Then again, I didn't really care. Like, honestly, as a child, whenever I would watch Dragon Ball Z on a weekly basis on Toonami, like, I always had thought that they seriously, like, did the whole entire episode within the week, between the last episode and the new one. Like, I seriously thought that they did all the animation and all the voicing and everything for it, so... Yeah, this is before I realized, oh wait, it takes several months for them to actually do the animation, and it takes about 3 weeks to do the voicing. Oh, come on, there we go. So, yeah, that really honestly shows you what I thought of when I was a kid. Dang it, I was trying to get trapped under there and die. Because I remember one time whenever I played this, once again going back to being a child, I actually somehow got lodged between the bee and the platform, and I got squished, and it instantly killed me. And ever since then, I have never been able to replicate it. But I will one day. Maybe. I don't really know. But anyways, seeing as how this is actually one of my favorite games from my childhood, I will try my best not to swear at all during the Let's Play, because I want to be a more positive influence for the children who watch my videos. Whoa, no, you're going the wrong way, dude. Well, whatever. And, well, there you go. I'm not even sure what the aspect ratio... Well, not aspect ratio. I'm not even sure what the ratio is between, like... how many children compared to, like, teenagers or adults watch my videos, because I know that you can go to the statistics and really find out, but that doesn't really give you an exact number. That only gives you percentages. Whoa! Okay, you almost got me there. Yeah, you know, whenever ominous music happens, things are about to get real. Holy crap, it's Purple Boba Fett! And he's riding some kind of suit. Whoa, hey, no, man, no, no. I will beat you. No, don't punch me. I'm gonna keep jumping and dodging your punches. Okay, or you can ram me like a jerk. Haha, look at this, I'm actually lasting and I'm blasting you upside your face. Ow. Come on, die. Ow. Okay, I've only got one bar of health left. Oh my! What the crap? That was not supposed to happen. Like, seriously, that really wasn't. That was not part of the storyline. For those of you who have played this, well, you already know what's supposed to happen. For those of you who have not played this, well, geez, like, you'll see what's supposed to really happen. Like, you're not supposed to win, alright? This is a scripted sequence, but he just decided to go rogue on me and, like, not even capture me. He just wanted to annihilate me. And you know what? I'm just gonna stand right on top of him, so that way he will at least go with the story. There you go. Jeez, Purple Boba Fett, you were breaking the rules. You worthless piece of scrap metal. Did you think you could defeat me? Well, I did at first, until you rammed into me and killed me and I had to redo this. To be honest, I really thought I stood a chance. Hey, what's that noise? Whoa, holy crap. Somebody give Purple Boba Fett a hand. He could really use one. And there he goes. Damn, I guess I'm not... Wait, damn? Now you won't see that on the Super Nintendo version. I do not remember that from my childhood. Well, okay. Alright, well, I have let the shocking settlement settle into my system, and... Alright, here we go. This character right here, his name is Zero, and he is over here trying to give X a pep talk. And there you go. I will explain who Zero is momentarily, but he's over here giving us a pep talk because we died on a scripted sequence, no less. Like, that's never happened before. Just, like, Purple Boba Fett decided to say, yeah, screw the script, I'm gonna kill you. You may even become as powerful as I am, but you'll never be as handsome. I'll scout ahead and collect as much information on Sigma's fortress as I can. I'll meet up with you when you get there. See you later. X, I know you could do it. I'm gonna go back to being in Marvel vs. Capcom 3, and I'm gonna be voiced by Johnny Young Bosch. See you later! And there you go. Zero is another Reploid that was actually created by Dr. Kane to fight against other Reploids who have gone Maverick. And if you're wondering what Reploids who have gone Maverick means, pretty much that means that they've decided to say, screw the rules! I don't feel like going by the script, and I'm gonna hurt people. So, Zero fights against these Mavericks, and X kind of wants to join him in his fight. And there you go. That's pretty much who Zero is. So, Zero fights against Reploids, X wants to be like Zero, and this is where I'm going to stop this video, because this being a side Let's Play, I do not want these videos to be too long. So, anyways, thank you all for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoy playing it and reliving my childhood. I'll see you on the next episode, where we are going to continue with the game and hopefully not die in scripted sequences. That was awkward.